Hi everyone, my name is Larissa. I'm a neurobiologist and a person with Charcot-Marie-Tooth disease or CMD. Today I'm going to review if there is any scientific evidence suggesting that taking collagen as a supplement can help CMT. Let's go. Let me start by saying that there are no studies assessing the safety and efficacy of collagen supplementation in CMT, in any of the types of CMT. I could basically finish the video right now, but given that many people with CMT are taking collagen as a supplement, hoping that it helps somehow, I believe this topic requires more investigation, and the people with CMT taking collagen require more convincing. So collagen is actually a collective name for several types of proteins, 28 subtypes to be precise, although three types, 1, 2, and 3 make up 80 to 90% of all the collagens. So really we should talk about collagens, plural, as the most abundant proteins in our body by weight. Collagens are the main components of the extracellular matrix. This is the stuff that is in between our cells and that gives structure to our tissues. Although different collagens are present in various tissues, as you can see in this picture for non-cartilage tissues on the left and cartilage tissues on the right, most people think about skin when they hear collagen. It is true that the breakdown of collagen and its decreased production with age makes us look older, and there is very little we can do about it. Most certainly, it does not help to apply collagen topically and hope that it will somehow integrate into our skin extracellular matrix. Unfortunately, it doesn't work like that. Collagen is a big molecule, and when applied as a cream or gel, it just sits on top of the skin. Well, it makes a good moisturizer, so you can use it as that, but don't expect anything more than that from collagen creams or gels. Ingesting collagen, a popular pastime of Japanese ladies, is also unlikely to help aging skin. As you can see in this video, Japanese supermarkets and convenience stores are filled with collagen supplements of different formulations, capsules, drinks, powders, etc. However, the results of the studies investigating the potential benefits of collagen supplementation for skin are inconclusive and controversial. So the reason why Japanese women look so good and often way younger than their actual age is probably the combination of several factors, such as genetics, good diet, active lifestyle, other skincare products such as sunscreens, and a habit to hide from the destructive UV rays of the sun, and not collagen supplementation. I should be so lucky, lucky. On the other hand, cartilage tissues are known as collagenous tissues, and so are particularly collagen rich. The logic then goes, because CMT is a disease that affects the musculoskeletal system and oftentimes leads to traumas of the ankle, the knee, the hip, supplementing collagen should help heal following such traumas and improve the strength of the cartilage. Again, unfortunately, it does not work like that. There is no robust clinical evidence that collagen supplementation speeds up healing following traumas where there's a strain or a fracture, neither in healthy people nor in people with CMT. It is possible to find clinical trials showing some benefits of collagen supplementation, that is collagen peptides, for osteoarthritis, skin wounds, and some other conditions. However, these studies have a small number of patients, usually less than 100 patients. They are over a relatively short period of time, for example, 3 to 4 months, and are not replicated in large-scale phase 3 trials. Therefore, collagen supplementation is not seriously considered as a treatment option for any kind of disease, trauma, or anything else. Some might think, well, it's not going to make my condition worse anyway, and it might be slightly beneficial. So what's the harm in taking collagen supplements? Well, just like with any other substance, collagen can cause side effects, such as over-deposition of collagen on the blood vessels, which can actually accelerate vascular stiffness and age us faster. So again, this has not been shown in a large number of people, but it's one of the concerns that should make you think about whether it's really worth taking collagen or not. In addition, because there haven't been any studies on collagen supplementation in CMT specifically, it is not trivial at all to predict the effect of such an intervention. Collagen is involved in many cellular processes, and by no means more collagen means better for the muscles, bones, nerves, or whatever other tissue we take. Interestingly, there is one study that explores how CMT affects the collagen composition of peripheral nerves. So this study was conducted in 2002. The researchers decided to see if there is any remodeling of the extracellular matrix in the nerves of people with CMT type 1, 1A, and some other types that were not specified. So the researchers took peripheral nerve biopsies from people with CMT, some other diseases, and controls. The researchers found an upregulation of collagens, namely collagen types 1, 3, 4, 5, and 6 in people with CMT1. Moreover, among all the diseases investigated, CMT1 biopsies showed the highest level of upregulation of collagens. This can be interpreted as the reaction to nerve fiber degeneration. So cells deposit more collagen to try and restore the degenerated axons which happen because of CMT. But ironically, this can actually work the other way. Too much collagen depositions might hamper the axon regeneration. Therefore, as you can see, we already have a high expression of collagens, which is the result of the disease of CMT. And so adding more as a supplement is very questionable. By the way, in this study, the researchers showed that other components of the extracellular matrix are also abnormal in CMT1A1. And so my suspicion is that this is one of the reasons why we feel like our body are very tight or rigid. At least I do feel like that, and I constantly want to stretch, but it's actually very hard to stretch. So this could be due to the abnormality of the extracellular matrix. Let me know in the comments below if you feel the same way, if you constantly want to stretch, but it's actually very hard to stretch because the muscles and everything, all the tissues seem very tight. So again, if you're still not convinced and want to boost your collagen production, if not for CMT, but for your skin or your joint health, then consider consuming more vitamin C, which is required for the synthesis of collagen. Actually, there are many nutrients that are required for the synthesis of collagen, but vitamin C is one of the major ones. So not only that, but vitamin C is also a powerful antioxidant, and it was even tested specifically for CMT1A. Vitamin C supplementation showed promising results in animal models of CMT1A, but failed to be of significant benefit in people with CMT1A. Nevertheless, it is an essential vitamin that must come from our foods. Therefore, try including more sources of vitamin C in your diet, such as citrus fruits, strawberries, peppers, broccoli, Brussels sprouts, and others. A topical application of vitamin C is also a good idea, as recommended by dermatologists, especially in the morning before you head out and expose your face to the sun. So that's it for today. Please subscribe, follow my YouTube channel, and leave a comment about whether you've been taking collagen supplements or not, whether you were considering taking them, whether you decided not to, thanks to this video, and what other supplements you'd like to learn about. Okay, bye-bye.